Super welcome back, everyone. This is Super House of Dead Super Ninjas. I'm Super Duke of the Super Bump. Let's get on with it. That is a tall ass tower that I have to make my way down. Alright, still the only upgrade I unlocked is the suit, right? Yeah. That's the one I have equipped. Don't know why it's still marked as new. I guess that will change after this run. By the way, the B button doesn't back out of a menu, which is the way my brain wants to think that it works. You have to actually go over here to play. Alright, made it to the boss of the Royal Sanctum once, and promptly got my ass handed to me. Let's see if I can make it a little further this time. This game is very Rogue Legacy-like, in that it is extremely difficult, and progress comes slowly and incrementally, and you just kind of have to stick with it. But when you do make progress, it's very satisfying. I'm trying to figure out that super jump thing, but wasted too much time. Luckily, there was a 1-up right there. A lot of diamonds in the walls of this place. The spelunky player in me is hoping that I get a pickaxe so I can mine the walls, get some of those diamonds. I don't know how that monkey didn't die when I hit it. Sure looked like I hit it. Aw, man, this sucks. Okay, it wasn't as bad as I thought it would be. I see you up there, pink dude. You know, if this was a lady ninja, you'd think it would be Super House of Dead Kunoichi, which is a female ninja. Stop appearing out of nowhere. It's really frustrating. You can tell because I'm talking through grit teeth. This is a great way to talk about a video game. Ninjinity? Okay, that's pretty good. Pretty good game, pretty good. You've won me over. If you haven't won me over already. It's a pretty good ninja move to cut someone in half with a whip. That takes a lot of ninjinity. Oh yeah, spikes. Sigh. Luckily those guys are easy enough to deal with, as long as you remember to jump over them after they die. Damn it! Such a hard jump to make. Eventually, I'll collect all of those letters and learn what they do. But today is not that day. Can I actually collect these after I throw them? I can't. Yeah, I do. Okay. I wasn't sure if I was imagining that or not. I did that. I did it again. The super jump. How did I? Is it a timing thing? Do I have to jump? Maybe I can only do that like after I dodge an enemy attack or something. Because if you've noticed, it will occasionally say, you know, nice moves or something after I dodge an enemy attack. So maybe that's the trigger for being able to do that super jump. I'm not sure though. I don't think it's right after I hit an enemy. Remember to duck under the spikes. Glad these demon enemies aren't that tough to deal with, because they're worth a lot of points. There I go, forgetting about those spike enemies again. How? I hit that monkey! I don't know. That is really most frustrating in this game so far. Is that? I killed the monkey and I still took damage. Oh, I took damage from that thing down below there, okay. But there are definitely instances where I hit these things and they don't die. Oh. Gotta keep my rage going. That didn't last as long as I would have liked. I don't know how to kill these glowing color thingies. Do I have to bomb those? Is that something only magic can kill, maybe? Well, magic took care of it, so that's one strategy, I guess. Not sure if only magic can hurt those things. All right. One ups out the wazoo. Okay, so when you run out of time, you still have a second or so before that Grim Reaper shows up. And sometimes I can't even tell if I'm taking damage or not. Those things hugging the walls look kind of like radioactive toast. To go with the radioactive waffle from Super Mario Bros. 3. Man, I don't even want to stop and read what those ghosts say. Because time is so precious in this game. Alright, I actually made it to the boss with the continue, I think. I can definitely feel myself getting better. Alright, so it's the one-armed ninja again. Went ahead and bust out some magic on this guy. Didn't work. Awesome. Shurikens don't work. Maybe I guess I have to hit him in the back. Ow! How was I supposed to dodge that? Oh, I guess I have to put some distance between us. Alright, well, this guy doesn't seem impossible. Let's give it another go. Magic just does not work on this ninja at all. That was close. Jeez! Alright, have to double jump to get over that. Okay, so I think he's only weak when he's flashing like that. Because that seems to be the only time I can hit him. Crap. Missed my shot. Yep, I'm pretty sure that's the case. Alright, well that'll make it easier to dodge, because I know I can only hit him in these specific time periods. One more. You can do this, dude. Come on. Hang in there. Hang in there. Yes! Wow. Oh my god. Oh boy. What the, okay. Whoa. Alright. Alright, so magic did not seem to do anything, so I'm assuming... Great! Yeah, I can definitely, I guess I have to stand on this thing when he does that. Alright, so I'm assuming he's only vulnerable when he opens his chest up like that. Well, that was enjoyable. I don't know why I always watch the beginning of that animation. Hey, new high score, awesome. I didn't unlock anything. You think I would have unlocked something for defeating the one-armed ninja, but I guess I have to do the whole boss fight to unlock anything from that. I wonder if that was... It sure looked like last boss material, but I don't know if I'm already at the last boss or not. Probably not, because I only made it to floor 150, and there's a whole lot more above that. Or below that, rather. Oh, I see. There's, like, a demon skull there. I guess that means that's, like, one of the bigger bosses in the game. And then it looks like I have, five more areas. And then another huge boss at the bottom of the tower, I think. I'm not sure. Oh well, that seems to be pretty substantial for this video. Nice stopping point there. So I'm gonna call it, and tune in tomorrow for more Super House of Dead Ninjas. I'm Duke of the Bump, goodbye.